हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू डॉक्टर नूर फिरदौस जहां चैनल वेर इन यू आर एक्सप्लोरिंग द वर्ल्ड ऑफ बिजनेस मैनेजमेंट विद डॉक्टर नूर। टुडे वी आर हियर टू डिस्कस द नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ कंट्रोलिंग, दैट्स द लास्ट फंक्शन ऑफ मैनेजमेंट दैट डील्स विद टाइप्स ऑफ कंट्रोलिंग। माय प्रीवियस वीडियोस आई हैव टॉट यू मीनिंग ऑफ कंट्रोलिंग, फीचर्स ऑफ कंट्रोलिंग एंड प्रोसेस ऑफ कंट्रोलिंग इज टॉट इन माय प्रीवियस वीडियो। प्लीज गो थ्रू दैट टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस पार्ट बेटर। And here I am teaching you different types of control. So before I start with this topic, let me check with you. Have you subscribed to my channel? If not, please do it right now, because it is only channel which covers full principles of management subject in 15 hours, consisting of 57 videos. 15 hours you can be thorough with management skills. This is only channel which provides that skill. So I request you to take advantage of this, subscribe to my channel, watch all my videos, share my videos, like my videos, and please don't forget to write comments, correct? With that request, let me start with the types of controlling. As you know, students, controlling is very important because it involves, correct, laying down standard, telling people what they have to do. And once they have performed it, measuring their performance and comparing their performance with the laid down standard. If any deviations are there, taking corrective action. If no deviations are there, then rewarding them. So that is what is called as controlling. Now when it comes to controlling, when to do controlling, the next question what manager will ask is when to do controlling. Correct? That's a very important topic which most of them want to understand. What is the right time to do controlling? That is what I am teaching you now. Types of controlling. Whenever you want to do controlling, there are three timings of controlling when you can do. You can do controlling before, correct, during and afterwards. So type of control based on timing of control. So most of you have this question, ma'am, when to control? Before I start activity, I have to control. Or during the activity I have to control, or I have to control after activity. So that is what I am doing you in today's class. Types of control based on timing of control. Based on timing of control, children, three types of controlling are there. Input, correct, then you have based on transform. As you know, if you see the system process, three steps are there. Input, process and output. Input, what are the work you are doing? Process, how you are doing it? Output, what is the result you have got? You can do control in all three times. If you are doing the control in the input itself, like I am taking class now, I want my delivery to be really good. So before itself I will take steps. That is called as feed forward control. Correct? So then next you have transformation process. When the work is happening, I will control. Correct problem as and when it is happening. That is what is called as concurrent control. And the third one is feedback control. So on the basis of timing, when you want to control, there can be of three types of control: feed forward control, concurrent control and feedback control. All three I will teach you in detail. I'll start with feed forward control. So focuses on preventing anticipated problems, since it takes place in advance of actual work activity. So on the basis of timing, the first type of control is feed forward control, where before I perform the activity, I will control myself. For example, I am taking the class. I want my class to have clarity, so I don't want any disturbance. So before I start my class, I will select the place where there is no disturbance. That is what is called as feed forward control. Correct? Which focuses on preventing, anticipating the problems and preventing it, so that when my work go on, it will not become a barrier. So if you are doing it well in advance, as a preventive measure, if you are controlling, it is called as feed forward control. Second type of control is concurrent control. Control control take place while an activity is in process. While I am taking in class itself, I see that slides are not coming clearly. Then so many times I will go and set it right. That is called as concurrent controlling. So it takes place when the activity is in process. It regulates ongoing activities that are part of the transformation or conversion process to ensure that they conform to the process of standard. So while taking the class itself, I will control myself. Okay, you are able to see the slide properly. You are able to hear me properly. So I am setting right then and there. That is called concurrent control. Then feedback control. Last type of control, what you have, we call it as feedback control. Feedback control, what happened is, now my class recording is over. So I have recorded full class. So almost it has come to an end. Then I will ask you in the write down the feedback, give your feedback in comment box, I will ask you. That is called as feedback control. That means class is already recorded and class is already played. You have seen my class. Then you are finding some difficulty, you are writing it in comment box. Ma'am, can you do this? Or ma'am, this was the problem. That is called as feedback control. That is, after performance of activity, if controlling is happening, it is called as feedback control. So most popular type of control in organization is this only. Complete work will be performed, then controlling will be done. For example, I have performed. I will look for my feedback from you. Correct? What feedback you are giving it to me? I wait for your comment. That is called feedback control. Most popular type which relies on feedback. This takes place after the activity is carried out. It regulates after a product or service has been completed in order to ensure that the final output meets the standard set. Also called as post-action control. It is also called as post-action control because once the full action is completed, I am controlling. Let me give you an example. I have given my own example. Now let me give you an example of a manager and sales executive. I have three sales executives. I want to control them. I have given them the standard 20-20 unit they have to sell. Now in the 20 unit, during feed forward control, what I will do is, well in advance only I will tell, see, to achieve 20 unit is not a joke, you need training. So as a preventive control, I will send them for training. I will clarify all doubts and then put them on field. That is called field forward control. A concurrent control, what I will do is, I myself will accompany them during sales call and see how they are performing, what problem they are facing. I try to understand that. That is called as concurrent control. The next you have, third is feedback control. I will not tell anything in 1 month. When 1 month is over, I will ask you to tell me what you have done. This person will tell, ma'am, I have done only 15 units. So there is a 5 unit shortage, I will tell him feedback, no, your performance is not up to the standard, 20 unit is expected, you have done only 15 unit, 5 unit shortage is there, no increment this time, please improve. That is called as feedback control. Did you get the meaning of all three types of control on the basis of time? It can be feed forward, it can be concurrent, or it can be feedback control. All three types of control are usually used in the organization to control their employees and ensure that employees are giving their best. Along with that, the next topic what I am taking you now is, it is called as the different types of system, organization control system. You may ask me, okay ma'am, on the basis of timing, I can do three types of control. But what are the control systems I have in organization? These are the control systems. So, organization, the next topic what I am teaching you is organization control system. The first type of organization control system is your management process. Like, what are the objectives my organization want to achieve? That's the first system which helps me to control, because I have to measure performance of employees based on this objective. So, the first control system, correct? For example, in an organization, what all the things I have to control? The first thing you have to control is your processes. Whatever process you have laid down, all the process people should follow. If they are not following it, then there is a problem. So the first step is, you have to do controlling of management processes. What all there in management process? The strategy, objective, policies, procedures, then selection, training, performance appraisal, job design, work structure, performance modeling, norms, organization culture, all this I have to control in the organization. That is what is called as control of management processes. That is called as organization control system. You have to control whether your policies are implemented properly. You have to control whether your performance appraisal is done properly or your procedures are followed properly or not. You have to monitor. That is what is the first type of organization control system, that we call it as management process. All these things will come. The second type of control, what you have to do is in terms of compensation and benefits. The second type of organization control system is compensation and benefits. See, they, no organization will survive if they don't have good people. As long as you are able to attract the best people to your organization, you can survive for longer. That is why you have to attract the best people and you have to retain them. And you have to motivate them to exert the maximum effort in their work. Recognize the value of their performance contribution. If the people, how much ever the best performance employees are doing, if the boss is not recognizing it, then people will give up. They think if I do well or I don't do well, boss is saying, he's no appreciation, no recognition. He don't even tap on my back saying that I have done good job, why should I do? So people will get irritated and they started looking for some other job and they may leave the organization. That is why the second type of organization control system is you manage your compensation and benefit properly. Ensure that your compensation and benefit act as a good motivator to the people and motivate the right people and ensure that people are giving their best in the organization. So you ensure that if you take care of compensation and benefit, the advantage is you can have the best people. You can retain the best staff and you can motivate the best people. Today, Microsoft is considered a number one organization and Microsoft is considered the best paying organization. The reason why they have come up is because of the best talent they are able to attract. They pay such good salaries, they give such good incentives, all people get attracted. If they dream to work for Google or to work for Microsoft, they all love to do it because of compensation and benefit. So second type of our control system is you take care of compensation and benefit and ensure that the good people are being rewarded and you value their contribution and you recognize their work. That is what is the second type of control system that is based on compensation and benefit. The third type of control system, which is very important, is employee discipline. No compromise on this. Because no organization will be successful one if their employees are not following discipline in the organization. So reporting time is at 9. 9, I want people to be there. That is discipline. Certain area in the organization is the smoke-free area. Smoking is not allowed there. You are not supposed to smoke there. You have to speak to your boss by following a particular decorum. You have to do that. Discipline is very important. You have to dress up in formal dress code. You have to come in formal dress code. You have to do a proper haircut. You have to shave yourself and come. You have to do that. That is what is called as discipline. What is discipline? Discipline is an influence. Discipline is defined as influencing behavior through reprimand. So discipline is defined as influencing behavior through reprimand. So how you are going to influence the behavior of others and make them perform better is what is called as employee discipline. Controlling is very important in employee discipline because discipline is not there, no organization will come up. So this discipline could be a progressive discipline. Ties reprimanded to the severity and frequencies of employee infraction. So progressive discipline, what happens is, if you come one time late, warning, two times late, pay cut, third time late, you may have to leave the job. That is called as progressive discipline. Step by step, the discipline measures are becoming severe. The next you have positive discipline. Positive discipline don't aim at punishing. How progressive discipline is. Positive discipline tries to involve people more positively and directly in making decisions to improve their behavior. Positive discipline don't want believe that a leader should not hold stick and control people. It is not going to help. I'm not going to do that. I'm going to tell people they have to perform well. I will create an environment where they self-discipline themselves. Self-discipline is very important for me. I don't want to stand with a stick and control them. That is called as positive discipline. So students, I am teaching you organization control system. The first type of control system was management processes, where system and procedures, whether it is followed or not followed, is checked. And the second one was compensation and benefit, where we check whether compensation and benefit is in line with employee's expectation. And third control system is discipline, where I am going to check whether employees are following discipline or not by using the two types of discipline, progressive discipline and positive discipline. So then the fourth type of organization control system what we have is information and financial, correct? The information and financial, very important types of control students. See, let it be any resource is scarce in the organization. No resources are abundantly available. Every resource there is a shortage. That is why optimum utilization of resources has to be done. That is why management is come to the picture. This control is going to help you that herein, I'm going to control the flow of information. I'm going to control the financial ability of the organization and ensure that we don't spend much money and bring the shortage of funds. Proper fund management is very, very important. That is what I am going to do here. And information should be flowed at the right time in the right direction. That is what is called as information control system. Activity-based costing, the true cost of all products and services to be measured. Economic value added, examine the value added by all activities. If you feel some activity is not adding any value, delete it, reduce the cost, because costs have to be less. That's a basic control you have to do in the organization. Then third one is understand the implication of key financial measures. Calculate the ratio analysis, find out whether you are performing well. Not performing well, take suitable action immediately. Don't wait for a long time and take measures. That is what is called as the information and financial control system. So I am teaching you the different types of control system. The first one was the management processes. The second one was employee compensation and benefits. Third one was discipline. Fourth one was information and financial. And the fifth one is operation and control system. So operation management and control system. What is operation? Buying product for the company. Don't you think controlling is important there? Because what happens is, if you buy in bulk and keep, it will occupy so much of space. You are paying rent for the space, which is of no use. And if your manufacturing is not happening, all inventory will pile up. Your liquidity position of your business will get affected. You will not have money to pay salaries to your employees or pay salaries to your vendors. You will have you make payment to your vendors. These kind of issues will pop in. So that kind of control, we called it as operation management control. That is, in the operation, while you are running the organization day-to-day activities, the controlling is done here. So the first controlling will start with purchasing. Ensure that you purchase at the right level. When your materials are reaching to a particular level, that is called as economic order quantity. When it reaches to EOQ level, then only place an order. Above that, never place an order. Below that, you may lose customers, because customers will say product is not available, they may leave the organization, right? They may not buy with you, or you may not able to do the right time delivery because you don't have supply with you. So purchasing, please take care, you place an order at proper time. Then project management, whenever you are managing the project, please follow the PERT technique of controlling to manage your project. That is program evaluation and review technique. PERT technique is program evaluation and review technique, which identifies and controls the many separate events in complex project. Project is very complex. So for example, I am doing one survey to find out customers' feedback on my product. So the first one, I am finding out the problem. So there I can control and see whether I am in right direction. Data collection, analysis of data, preparation of report. Each step I can control. That is what is called a PERT technique of control, which I can use in project management. Whenever I have project management happening in the organization. Then the last one is statistical quality control. Very important students, QC. Quality control is very important. Whatever activity you do in organization, ensure that the quality is taken care. Based on the establishment of upper and the lower class limit that can be geographically and statistically significant, you have to ensure that you are maintaining the quality control. The expected level of quality is there in all types of activities, whatever you are doing it. Never you compromise on your quality. That is what is called as statistical quality control. So whenever you are dealing with the operations management control, these are the three types of control you can use on the basis of purchasing, on the basis of project management and on the basis of quality control. So in an typical organization system, if these type of controls can be followed and implemented as per the requirement, as and when it is required, then never organization will have problem, and organization will always be the first one to achieve its goal, and organization will reach to the top level position in the market. That is what is the power of controlling, students. That is why controlling is considered as very, very important. So today's class, I taught you the different types of control on the basis of time, that is feed forward, feedback, and concurrent control. And I also discuss about the different types of controlling system a typical organization may have. It can be an operation management control, or it can be employee discipline control, or it can be information and financial control, or employee compensation control, or it can be management process control. Hope you understood, students. So that's all I have today. So I came to the last part of my controlling chapter. So nothing is remaining now, students. I have done my duty. So the controlling chapter comes to an end. So the last function in management, controlling, we have completed. So thereby, my course on principles of management come to an end. Today is my last class on principles of management subject. Because everything, right from the meaning of management till controlling, everything I have covered. So, and totally 57 videos I have made in my playlist. Please go through all 57 videos, and these 57 videos will last long for 15 hours. The full subject, my objective of starting this course was inculcating management skills in you. 15 hours, the management skills are inculcated in you, through which you can manage your organization effectively, and you can manage your personal life effectively. You can become a good entrepreneur. You can become a good manager. You can become a good homemaker. You can become a good student. You can, so the objective, remember the, my first video when I introduced the introduction to management, I told you all these are my aim. And today in the last video, I am recalling myself and telling this is what we have done. So please watch video, write down comments, and please let me know any other course in the business management you want me to take up next in the comment box. Definitely I will design that course and bring it to you. So till then, you know what you have to do. So please keep watching all my 57 videos and inculcate the management skills, and share all my videos to your friends. Help them to become better managers and help them to lead a very successful life in leading the life in systematic way. So please subscribe to my channel and keep waiting for my next course, which I'll be launching based on your requirement. So write down in the comment box the next course what you want me to launch in the YouTube. So I'll design the course and I'll get back to you with the next course. So till then, thank you so much for viewing my video. I think I have 2000 views now, and I have 109 subscribers. That's really wanted to thank all of you for your support and watching my videos. But your support don't come to an end now. In fact, it starts now, because what benefit you got, others should get that benefit. So looking forward for your support, looking forward for your support and blessings for the growth of my channel. So till then, I pray Almighty to shower His best wishes on you and blessings on you. So please take care. Okay? See you soon with my next video. Yeah. So please take care. Bye.